Welcome to Dial M for Films. Producer Guneet Monga was just 20 years old when she assisted her best friend's mother, line producer Anirudhya Sehgal, on the film Valley of Flowers in Delhi. 9 years later, in 2012, Guneet was featured as one of the 12 international players to watch in the Hollywood Reporter's Women in Entertainment special. At 29, Guneet had already spent 6 years in the business in Mumbai, pushed the accelerator on the co-production model for financing independent Indian films, and went on to put close to 15 Indian titles like Gangs of Wasseypur, Monsoon Shootout, The Lunchbox in prestigious international film festivals across the world. As she closes in on finishing another epic decade in the industry, Guneet has steadily built impressive international clout as a producer and a diverse Indian slate for her company, Sikhya Entertainment. Guneet, welcome to Dial M for Films, and thank you for making the time.
Thank you, Smriti. It's always such a pleasure to speak to you. Thank you for having me here.
Guneet, let me start by congratulating you on a couple of things, because with you, there are always a couple of things, there can never be one. You started a cinema collective, Indian Women Rising, with Tahira Kashyap Khurana, Ekta Kapoor and Ruchika Kapoor in January this year. Mm-hmm. Karishma Dev Dubey's Bittu, the short film that IWR backed, made it to the Oscar shortlist. The deluge of love coming in for your film Paglet is still going strong. And last week, you were awarded the second highest civilian French honor. So congratulations.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Listen, I also want to acknowledge that we are doing this in the middle of a raging pandemic. The situation is really dire outside, but I just felt, and so did you, Guneet, we chatted about it just before the session, that it's very important at a time like this to just carry on, you know, just find that strength to keep doing what we do. There are wonderful people on this session, Guneet, who want to talk to you, and some of them are COVID positive. So their questions, they will be listening to you and their questions probably the team will ask. But so I'm starting this session with a slight, you know, heavy heart. But before we go back, I wanted to talk to you about what's happening right now. Because of the pandemic, we've got a moment of pause. Where are you at professionally, Guneet, today? I always get the feeling you're doing too much. Are you doing too much?
You know, this is really, really hard time. It's been, I think, especially for what I do, I need to bring my entire energy into the room to be able to have a buy-in for my stories. So it's a lot of faith. It's a lot of, like, you know, especially working with a lot of young first-time writer directors. It's always that I need to be in the room to be able to sell something. I didn't know any other way of doing this. You know, I need to hold somebody else's hands and say that, you know, this will be amazing. Trust me, you know. And that does not come over a Zoom. So my world is upside down, you know. So I don't know how to, I didn't know enough how to do this. 2020 March was very, very tough. Couple of months were tough to understand how to work from home. But what we did at Sikhya, that we were able to diversify. We doubled down on podcast. We doubled down on short content that we did for Flipkart. And we just made it work somehow. We made the last year work by doing really innovative, cool stuff and double down on development process. We're glad that we were able to finish Surya Rai Potru. We were able to finish Paglet, put those out there in 2021 and 2021. But now the second wave is unexpected. This is just emotionally draining us more than anything else. In terms of work, we have our next projects lined up. We have a big announcement coming up soon. Everything that we have developed over 2 years, you know, I think role of a producer is also packaging, is in the process of packaging. Things like that can happen on a Zoom. It's still very limiting, but what the thing is, that the whole world is experiencing this together. It's not like one city in one world is experiencing it and we are talking about it. So everybody is extremely proactive about, you know, having more empathy over Zoom and having more faith and still making things move, because like we said, you know, the show must go on, and there is a hope that we will all find creative ways of making content, which is very, very tough right now. But it has to keep going on. So we are pushing. We are pushing on development. We are pushing on research. You know, and the teams are staying together, which is the biggest thing.
But, you know, Guneet, you spoke about finding innovative ways of doing things and the fact that it's very important to pivot, you know, at times like these to figure out as to how to take the piece forward. But this has sort of also defined your professional approach to things. Because when you moved to Mumbai, moved in the sense you came to Mumbai in 2006, you moved in 2008. But when you came to the city, you first of all came with 50 lakhs from your neighbor, Mr. Kamlesh. We will get to that. We will get to why that money was given to you. What kind of, first of all, preparation did you make? Did you do actually to even come to Bombay?
Yeah.
You know, I'm going to come to Bombay when a person living in Delhi who's got considerable experience doing a lot of things connected to film decides to make that move at a time like that. What is the kind of preparation did you do, and why did Mr. Kamlesh give you 50 lakhs?
You know, my Bombay move is a very sweet story. I was doing a lot of international films as a production person, moving from an intern to a location manager, production manager, line producer, to India project person. I knew a lot of below the line people in Bombay. Like, I knew gaffers, I knew light boys, I knew catering, I knew just really, really, like, you know, people who I got along with on my sets and I was closing their deals. I knew light vendors as, like, they were my friends. So that those were the people I knew, you know. But I have to say that my friends made it happen for me. And I'm really glad that now the industry also knows them so well. So actually the people who looked for houses for me were Siddharth Diwan and Mukund Gupta. We are all college friends. We are all very, very close. We were all college best friend gang. So it was Prerna, me, Siddharth, Mukund, Ambika, lots of us, seven of us. And Sid and Mukund had already come here. And he was actually working at Grips in Bombay. So we were all discussing, and Prerna was an FTII. She's an editor. Siddharth was working for Grips, and so was Mukund at that point in time before he went into art department. And they were looking for a house for us, you know, so they looked for a house, and Prerna was at FTII. So she had a peer group who was moving from Pune to here. So I was in Delhi and I was like, okay, my friends are there, I should also go. And plus, you know, maybe I want to do, I mean, I've grown up on Yash Raj and Kejo and just 90s, and my house used to be next to Savitri Cinema. So I've grown up on that cinema. So I wanted to come and do Hindi language film, jo matlab mere maa baap bhi dekhenge aur, you know, bolenge ki acha kuch kiya. So I came here and I they looked for a house in Goregaon, and it was a 1 BHK that both Prerna and I shared. And in fact, Prerna's uncle, her Taya ji's friend's son was Abhishek Chaubey, who they had called and said, you know, we are sending our girls, and he was a party putra, you know. So it is just very sweet story, you know, like everybody. And I remember I only knew Vinay Pathak. He was a part of Partition, one of my previous films, international films. So Vinay sir was asking me, do you need something? Another woman I'd worked with, Shraddha, the actor, beautiful. So she like sent ghar se crockery and, you know, chadre, tumhe kya chahiye? I remember Prerna and I having one almari, ek shelf uska, ek shelf mera, and one BHK. And literally, you know, we went bartan shopping at Andheri station because wahan se suna tha ki saste mein milte hain. So, you know, and it is literally, matlab hum log ek thoda elevated sacha wala ghar ghar khel rahe the ki hum log apna furniture chun ke lenge aur fir ab hum logon se milenge, you know. So it really started from there. And Prerna's group was my immediate group of her friends from FTII. And my group was just, yeah, that's Prerna. And Siddharth Diwan also, I think you have spoken to. But yeah, so
we've not spoken to Siddharth as yet. He still has to give us time. But Prerna, we've had on the show before. She's an editor. So just for everyone's information, yes.
And Prerna has been like a wall. Like, Prerna has been my closest friend. We've been friends for same school, and we cleared the entrance and got into the same college. and which is very rare for having your school friends into the same college after. And then we came, and I interned with her mother, and we came to Bombay together. I think till a point of time, our resumes were also together. It was like Guneet, Prerna, comma, Prerna, and same resume, same people. So, in fact, when I did Salaam India, Prerna was like the production person. Like, she's always been my wall, you know, and moved to being an editor on, you know, like even from Peddlers to Paglet, you know, Tigers, just everything. So it's home with her. And having that friendship was important. Having, again, like a peer group was important. And I went and stayed at her FTI college with her. So I made her group friends. So it was just those people. And all of us came here with a dream, with a hustle, that we'll go to offices, we'll meet more people, we'll ask for work. And step by step, we systematically did that. Jo kaam mila kiya. I started in working with Anand Mahindru. He introduced me to Rang Rasya. He wanted an executive producer. Jo jahan mila, in fact, Prerna's friend Puneet Khanna introduced me to, who also now has directed a film, introduced me to Anand Mahindru. So, you know, it was everybody sharing contacts, everybody saying, ki, acha, isse milo, wahan par ek job opening hai. And then you start building your work friends, you know, and slowly we graduated from a 1 BHK in Goregaon to a 2 BHK in Lokhandwala, to our individual homes after that, to our individual massive cupboards, you know, but we started somewhere. Yeah.
But, you know, in 2007, your first film, Say Salaam India, came out. And, you know, the reason I want to talk about it is, first of all, how did it happen? And, you know, that was actually the beginning. That film was actually the beginning of you, you know, going out there because you wanted to recover the money that you had put in there, trying out a distribution model that people had not really tried.
Yeah, you know,
this is a little bit about that.
Yeah, this is a really crazy story because my neighbor in Delhi, we were tenants, and he was, you know, the owner of the apartment. It's a big deal. He told me that tune mass communication padha hai, because we were all friends from mass communication college. So tune mass communication padha hai, to mujhe na ek studio khulna hai. So tu, you run the studio. And I was like, achha, ye studio kya karega? So they said, ye studio matlab chote chote babies ki na videos banayega, cute cute videos. So more like, you know, baby videos, shadi videos, stuff like that. And tujhe ye camera camera sab aata hai aur tu ye filmon bhi kaam kar chuki, to tu kar le. So then I asked him, I said, what is your budget to open the studio? He said, you know, whatever, 50 lakhs, you know. So he said, I told him, it's a very bad idea, sir. You know, you should give me this 50 lakhs and I will go to Bombay and make a movie. I was 21. I didn't know what I was saying. I was just fascinated. And back of my mind, Prerna was doing post-graduation in FTI and she was planning to move to Bombay. So, mujhe bhi Bombay jana tha apni dost ke beech beech. Ambition to itna hi tha. So, thoda inseparable se the hum, you know. So, I was planning to come to Bombay. How, what, where? We had to figure it out. And Kamlesh sir agreed, you know. Kamlesh Agarwal agreed and he said, okay, theek hai. I came here with a startup capital of 50 lakhs. And I met people at food courts in Infinity Mall, in many malls, and said, "Mere paas 50 lakh rupees kaha nahi hai." Then I started meeting all the gaffer people and everybody, and I said, "Agar tum kisi writer director ko jante ho, to mujhe milwa do, you know, ki hum kaise kaam karenge saath mein." So I remember Kamlesh, Moolchan, just so many people I knew introducing me to one person, then one AD introducing me to somebody else. I started building a network, you know, and I met a lot of people in Mahada with, like, you know, Khurle chain button and बहुत सारी थी बहुत अलग अलग किस्म के लोग because some people thought कि हम इसके 50 लाख रख लेंगे
you know of course
छोटी सी बच्ची है इसको तो हम रख लेते हैं
I think 95% of the people you must have met were thinking that
yeah सब मुझे स्कीम दे रहे हैं कोई मुझे कुछ बेच रहा है कोई मुझे कुछ बेच रहा है last in first out models and I'm learning on the go you know because everybody is giving me a business plan now it is the best way to learn you know to where everybody gives you a business plan and you're like, okay, you grow your own brains through that. You're just like, okay, this is what they are saying. And then you ask so many questions because you are sitting on a bunch of money and you can afford to ask so many questions. My dad used to tell me that, you know, anytime you go to a new city, new business, you start something, get the best CA and get the best lawyer. So this was like my core fundamental thing. So I started doing meetings with the best CA in the town and the best, and I said, you know, I'm very young. I only have this. I have some exposure, but I'd love to stay guided. So I was always protected. That is rule number 101. If you're starting a shop somewhere brand new, just go to town, meet a few CAs and meet a few lawyers, just so that you can also, you know the language, you can also know, and you know, it's professional fees that you pay and you understand the way of life. So eventually I did meet the director, Subhash Kapoor, who also had access to half the money. I raised another 25 lakhs. So he had 75 lakhs. Humne 1.5 crore mein Salaam India banai. And in 2006, we were thinking we are very, very cool because we it's such a sweet poster after so long. At that point of time, I was speaking 3 films.
Yes.
Yeah. And so we were thinking we are very cool because we were in 2006 making this as a run up to 2007 World Cup. So हम लोग सोच रहे थे कि हम लोग मतलब फटाफट हम लोग एक timeline पे थे, हम लोग एक urgency पे थे, खत्म करते हैं, and then we will tap into the global pan India marketing of we'll be a cricket film in the World Cup season and it'll be so cool and we'll get shows and we'll get. So we were working to that business model. And we finished our film in time. It was amazing to work with Subhash sir and the whole team. And it was a classic underdog film, rich school, poor school, you know, and how last ball pe the poor school wins. And it was beautiful, you know. At that point of time, I was really, really excited for this epic sports film, which was my first film. I'd give you that high, ki usne wo kar diya, you know, the ambition. So it was that trajectory of film. And then we were trying to take it out in the market and sell it. Ad Labs actually picked it up. At that point of time, it was Ad Labs run by Manmohan Chetty. And they picked it up and they said, we will do P&A and we will release your movie. And we were very excited. Ki ab ye ho raha. And their idea was to do this again, last in, first out. They will come in last. They will put the marketing money. They will release it. They will recover their money. And then what comes, they will give it to the producers. And then our investors make money back. Very sure of our film. We were happy. We were excited. We were happy to get a distribution deal. And then we started getting a lot of free things from brands because of World Cup and everything. We had thought Reebok was giving us money. Somebody was giving us 25 lakhs. Somebody was giving 30 lakhs. So we started building more and more marketing gigs around this. Sitting in those AC rooms, it was like India. And cut to, I mean, this is literally a real life documentary in my head. Cut to India ki team tayar hokar World Cup pe ja rahi hai. Unko Sahara mein lands mil rahe hain. उनको इतना मतलब यहाँ पे प्रशंसा मिल रही है एंड दे आर ऑल गोइंग टू 2007 वर्ल्ड कप एंड देन द फर्स्ट मैच दे लूज एंड यहाँ तो मतलब इंडिया में सब पागल बवाल बन जाता है एंड इट इज 24 कंट्रीज द फर्स्ट एलिमेंट्री राउंड उससे 5 साल पहले इंडिया हैड वन द इंडिया वाज इन सिल्वर विद ऑस्ट्रेलिया सो इट वाज इन द फाइनल्स एंड ऑस्ट्रेलिया हैड वन बट इट्स अ वेरी गुड टीम इंडिया इज अ वेरी गुड टीम एंड ऑफ कोर्स ऑब्सेशन एंड लव फॉर क्रिकेट एंड फर्स्ट मैच इंडिया लॉस्ट यहाँ उनके मतलब पुतले जल रहे हैं यहाँ लोग पागल हो रहे हैं मतलब बवाल हो गया कि वर्ल्ड कप में पहला मैच इंडिया हार गया सेकेंड मैच दे हैव गॉन एंड मेड 400 प्लस रन्स द हाईएस्ट इन एनी टाइम इन वन डे सीरीज एंड दे आर आर हीरोज यू नो एंड वी आर बैक टू आर कॉन्फ्रेंस रूम वी आर सो कूल वी आर पुटिंग आउट आर लिटिल फिल्म यू नो एंड ऑफकोर्स एंड आई रिमेंबर द मार्केटिंग हेड्स एट दैट पॉइंट ऑफ टाइम टेलिंग मी of course India is going to go forward. I mean, this is elementary round. Iske baad quarterfinals, semi-final, finals, you know, bahut sare round hai. And the third match is the deciding match. And of course India is going to win it because itna paisa laga. I remember Setmax had reduced their screen to 75%. And there were ads going on in 25% of the screen because of cricket. And this was happening for the first time. Pepsi had come out with Pepsi Gold. Samsung had come out with new TVs. And it was cricket full on because 5 साल में एक बार होता था and the last match happened a day before that Pakistan's coach Bob Wilmer died and mysterious death and it was crazy and we are getting affected our 1.5 crore ki film you know hamara kya hoga the third match India lost and people matlab pure desh mein havan chal raha tha uske liye it was pin drop silence that day people there were news stories people died of heart attack because India lost the match मतलब लोग बाल दे रहे थे तिरुपति में एंड यू नो नॉर्थ में हवन चल रहे थे फॉर इंडिया टू विन द डिसाइडिंग मैच इंडिया लॉस्ट एंड देयर आर फिल्म वाज इट हैड रिलीज्ड इन सिनेमास विद लाइक डब्बास ऑफ लाइक द एट दैट टाइम देयर वर रील्स द डिस्ट्रिक्ट ऑल द सिनेमा ओनर्स कॉल्ड एंड सेड ये डब्बे वापस लेके जाओ हमारे सिनेमा जल जाएंगे अगर क्रिकेट की बात होगी
डब्बे वापस
लेके व्हाट मतलब आर फिल्म रिलीज्ड एट लीस्ट गिव इट इट्स चांस You know, and all cinema owners like, pick purani film de do. Namaste London chalne lag gayi, Bheja Fry chalne lag gayi, जो पुरानी फिल्में थी जो एक दो हफ्ते पहले भी आई थी उनको डबल डाउन करते हैं. पीपल रैन टू सिनेमाज बट नोबडी वांटेड टू थिंक टॉक अबाउट क्रिकेट. शट देयर फॉर दिस थिंग एंड नमस्ते लंदन एंड भीरा फ्राई रिमेंबर बिकेम ह्यूज बिकॉज पीपल जस्ट रैन टू सिनेमाज फॉर सम सॉर्ट ऑफ रिलीफ सम सॉर्ट ऑफ एंटरटेनमेंट. द ओनली थिंग ऑल सिनेमा ओनर्स डिड नॉट वांट वाज अ क्रिकेट मूवी.
Exactly.
So that just led me, and I at that point of time was line producing Gajni, and I was like, what do I do? Like, how do I even go back home? This person gave me, trusted me with money, and it is such sense of responsibility. He said, like, how do you live and not return somebody who's trusted you? You know, he was always amazing. He's like, you need to understand this is business. And I said, no, sir, if I am not able to return you the money, then I don't deserve to be in this industry. Like, I was that sincere child who's like, I need to, like, sense of ownership, sense of responsibility. So I resigned from Gajni. I went back to Delhi. I didn't know how, what will I do. But I don't know, being in my house, I went to my school because I only knew my school and college. And I asked my principal, Mrs. Suman Kumar, and I said, you know, bachpan mein aap 50 rupaye par bachcha pe hum log jaake picture dekhte the. We saw Mungeri Lal ke Haseen Sapne, we saw so many films cinema mein jaakar. You know, would you, and Kalpana is also here from my school. So I really reached out to her. I used to be a prefect in school. I used to, like, you know, be very out. Like, I used to speak to her very often. So I had that sense of comfort with her. So I reached out to her and I said, you know, would you be able to collect? We had around 2,000 kids in school and around 1,000 kids. I said, would you be able to collect to do one show? You know, maybe class 6 onwards or whatever. And she said, yes, 50 rupees per kid. I went to Sapna Cinema behind my house. And I said, subah 9 se 12 ke show mein aap kitne paise lete ho? So कितने कैसे पैसे कमाते हुए थे? सिर्फ 5 से 7 हज़ार. I said, I'll give you 10,000. Will you give me the entire cinema? The cinema was 1,000 seater. So 50 kids, 50 rupees per kid, 1,000 seater, 50,000 का एक show, 10,000 मेरे cinema वाले के, 40,000 मेरे. So I made that business model. The kids came. They were like in the last ball, like jumping on their seats. You literally, I was the first time those 1,000 kids, I could hear their breath go. You know, like, just with every ball, with every magic, it was literally hitting the target audience. And the joy of seeing a house full of 1,000 kids, and as the crescendo goes up, and then they're like, you know, the poor kids won, you know, and it was just beautiful.
So how much money did you make?
40,000 from that show.
With this model.
Yeah, then I went to my college, and then I doubled and I got interns to work with me, and then it came on autopilot. Then I got to many more schools. I went to DPS RK Puram. I did that with Sangam. Then other DPSs got activated, and then when this got onto autopilot, I went and sold the interval to brands for another 15,000 rupees to do sampling with the kids. And I sold all the audio CDs outside. I put stalls and sold all the audio CDs, and I did 350 shows like this, and I made all the money back.
Oh my God.
Nine months.
Did ahead. You taste blood?
Yeah, I was like, I can do this. Yeah.
No, but this is what an incredible story. And also met your partner at Sikya, Achin,
yes.
Who was one of your interns, right?
Yeah, because he was in my college. I went to my college and I said, you know, I, if I have to activate one school, it takes me 1 week. You know, principal meets, writes this letter, collects the money. I said, I need more people, otherwise I won't be able to do this. And then 27 boys on bikes were my interns, and they used to come home and then go to their schools. So there was a day in my life and there were 15 shows in Delhi running together. And one day I asked all of them, I didn't even know their names. I said, aapke koi kharche nahi hai, I have to reimburse you. Petrol, exceptionally beautiful Excel sheet with everyone's name, with everyone's expenses, with toll road expenses. It's like so detailed, beyond my imagination detailed. I said, who made this? And one hand went up and it was Achin Jain. And I was like, which year are you in? He said, second year. I said, you should drop your college and come to Bombay with me. Hum log saath mein picture banayenge. And he did. And
so hard work pays, na, Gunit. You noticed Achin because Achin did work.
Yes. And now he's a partner at Sikya. He's my lifeline. He runs the company. He's a producer of everything. And the reason I'm able to do whatever I do, I travel, I open doors globally, it's because there is Achin here making things work, you know, and Achin is one of the most, is the biggest gift and, you know, runs Sikya. So very, very grateful for that.
You know, another thing like this distribution model, and, you know, we spoke about this earlier when we were just privately chatting before we got onto, you know, the session, that you had a line production company. You've done line production even before this, before you moved to Bombay, and Speaking Tree, became one of the line production companies that you started before Sikya. that got a credit on Gajni. And so this was also started by you, that line production companies actually started to get acknowledged in the credits of movies. Guneet, I want to move to co-productions, because in 2006, when you started, when you came here, co-productions were rare. People still don't understand what co-productions are and how they work. You accelerated the co-production piece. Give us a stepwise mapping out of how you did this. Why was it necessary? Why had no one done this prolifically before this? And how do co-productions actually work? That is 5 questions, but chalo, aap answer karo.
Yeah, now I'll go on a monologue. A large part of my learning came from going to Film Bazaar. I always say going to film festivals is very, very important. Even when you don't have anything to do, just go attend it. Just go listen to the talks, apply for a workshop, figure out how many sections there are, you know, what all you can attend. Having a film festival footprint expands your horizon of possibilities, of opportunities. Sapne kaun se dekh rahe hain? Matlab humare goals kya hain? Articulation aa jata hai. So going to Film Bazaar at that point of time really, really helped me. And I got this Rotterdam scholarship. There was a tie-up with Rotterdam and Film Bazaar, and I got this Rotterdam scholarship where I was with 60 young producers around the world who were attending workshops in Rotterdam. And that's where I started understanding how does Europe work? How does the whole rest of the world work? So basically, India is in 100% equity market. It is either a studio money, or it is a rich person's money, or any kind of money which is equity, which needs to be 100% raised and 100% returned with interest, and then of course profit share.
But so just to make it clear, 100% equity means the money is all coming from here. The money is going back all here. So the market is India. Yeah. So either it's a rich studio.
So equity means it is the nature of the money. So the nature, the money can be from anywhere. But if your project is 100 rupees, you need to raise the 100 rupees and return 100 rupees plus interest plus profit. This is basic expectation from anybody being in this business in India. So the nature of money is called equity. So equity can come to you from studios, can come to you by film financiers, can come to you by individual financiers, can come to you by uncles and aunts, can come to you by crowdfunding, can come to you from US, but it needs to be returned with interest as basic, like basic 101 of business in India. Whereas Europe, the whole of Europe, UK, Australia, New Zealand, Canada, film funding is taxpayers' money. It is art and culture. It is run by the ministry. It's run by the government. And you need to make applications to raise money for your work. You know, so there is a process, like there are TV sales, so you need to like make, and then there are state funds, there are city funds, there are central funds, there are script funds, then there are diversity funds. So you need to constantly make applications. So life of a producer is just like, I need to raise this. There is no pressure of, you know, returning the money with interest and profit. It is art and culture. It's under a ministry called art and culture. And taxpayers' money is seen, that filmmakers are seen as people who are taking art to the next level, and taxpayers' money is funded to them. So that is how rest of the world works.
Is it only for independent projects? Because otherwise you've got big studios.
We have Gomo. We have, you know, like big studios there who also work like how studios work here. But a large part of filmmaking culture is run by the government. And you scale up to a point where you can then take studio monies and you can use equity money. But it is, but large part of your credibility comes with grants. So if there is an independent producer there, they'll be writing applications. Here we will be meeting people, there they'll be writing applications. That's like to understand. And then each country has co-production treaties. And then you start saying, okay, if my crew is from here, or if I'm shooting in this part of the country, then I can access their state funds also. So everyone is constantly thinking, if I get into France and Germany, and then you get into another fund because you have activated 2 European countries, then your Emerge is a fund. So there are all these funds. There is all this process. US works very differently. US is a combination of equity and international sales and some sort of taxpayers, tax rebates, like where you are shooting. So US is extremely more creative in terms of how they fund their films. And I'm talking about independent films, where if you are telling a story and if your budget is 100, right, what they will do is they will at least try and raise 50, 60, at least 70 from outside US sales.
Hmm.
Sales that this project should be, because English language travels the rest of the world. It is one of the most genius models. So they try and get maximum money out of like 70% out of international sales, 60, 70% at least. So that is the first way of saying I have secured this much. Against that, they take bank loans or they take mezzanine funding or they take, but those kind of number, those kind of contracts come in. Then the balance 30% is either 10% is equity, where you take, you know, personal's wealth or, you know, returnable money, like I explained. And next 10, 15% or making up is where we are shooting, tax rebate, grants, anything that one can apply to. So that is how
I want to ask you a very basic question. Sorry to interrupt you. All these co-production treaties that are available that also inform you that this is what you can do with this country, this is what you can do with this country, where are these available?
Online.
Online. They're available online for people to, and where exact, I mean, I'm not saying give us the URL, but for a person who's trying.
Your ministry, your IND ministry, or all of them, they have it freely available with every country. Their rules, their applications, it's freely available at the IND.
For a budding producer, it's very important to inform your passion.
Yeah.
With all avenues that are available for funding, right? Yeah,
absolutely. Absolutely. You have a piece of content. How are you fundraising for it? You know, you can't be in a room thinking ki koi mujhe aake paise de dega, main art bana rahi hu. You know, aise nahi hota. You know, so you're just like, aap kaise raise kar rahe ho? Aur aap कैसे उसको वापस करने का प्लान कर रहे हो? आपको वापस करना है, नहीं करना? नहीं करना तो कितना नहीं करना? यू नो, सो दैट स्टार्ट्स इनफॉर्मिंग यू. व्हाट आल्सो हेल्प्ड मी अ लॉट वाज ब्रेकफास्ट प्रोग्राम एट कैन. सो देयर इज अ प्रोड्यूसर्स ब्रेकफास्ट प्रोग्राम एट कैन. आई अटेंडेड दैट. आई वाज एक्चुअली रेकमेंडेड बाय IFP इन न्यूयॉर्क. दे रेकमेंडेड माय नेम फ्रॉम इंडिया टू अलाउ मी टू अटेंड इट, एंड दैट इनफॉर्म्ड मी ब्यूटिफुली. Then they also recommended me. I was also picked up for a TAP program, Transatlantic Partnership Program, which was a week in Berlin, a week in Halifax, Canada, and a week at IFP New York. So those three programs, these were all scholarships that I won. And these were all showing up at festivals, figuring it out, how other people do it. And with that scholarship, it informed me on how these states are run, how these fundings are run. And I built a peer group, which has been the most important for me. And, you know, people I can ask, young producers around the world, and introduced me to lawyers and sales agents and how they work, how their contracts look. So it was a year-long program that you go with a project called Transatlantic Partnership. And these programs informed me the hustle that I need to put in. What is the work that I could do? What is the possibility? And I could able to ask questions. So I think, you know, my company is called Sikhya Entertainment, which means keep learning and keep growing. So I'm such a seeker at heart. You know, my curiosity levels are so high on everything, you know, and I just want to know everything, you know, and then when I go deep into it, I can't stop. I need to keep going on. And then I need to test the model and make it happen. It was almost like जो भी मैं अगली पिक्चर कर रही हूँ वो मैं इंटरनेशनल कोप्रोडक्शन ही करूंगी क्योंकि मैं इतना पढ़कर आ गई हूँ. You know, so and monsoon shootout, we got first half of our money by Arte France TV sales. You know, that was the first chunk of money that came in for monsoon shootout, and that is non-returnable money because it was we pre-sold Arte TV rights of only France territory. Things like this had not happened by then. And then when I started working on Lunchbox again, I met Pritesh at a film festival. And when I started working on Lunchbox, we started going to film festivals, started going to script doctors, script labs, co-production labs. And it is like a train that you're on, you know. So you go there, you go very well prepared with your pitches. I think Ritesh and I would have pitched Lunchbox at least 300-400 times. You know,
I want to stop you for 2 seconds and just ask you, just for the sake of everyone who's listening in or will listen in the future on YouTube, that while you're doing all these things, Guneet, you're taking all these flights, you're taking all these leaps, you're doing all of this, how are you running the kitchen?
So I was always, so I you know, have always been, I still do that. I still consult. I still do a lot of side hustle. I'm always consulting. I'm always I think firstly, you have to figure out what is your lifestyle. You know, I've had such huge personal ups and downs in life. Like I feel like my lifestyle has always been limited and I'm very happy.
Got it.
So my needs were very low. I used to stay in a 25,000 rented house and had some savings. And I used to line produce ads. I also worked with, I ran a company called Anurag Kashyap Films. And we used to only draw out basic, like, you know, basic rent and car fuel that is needed. I used to take 40-hour flights. You know, I've never bought into any kind of, like, whatever it takes. I remember during Gangs of Wasseypur and Peddlers, when they finished, I had moved to France for a month and a half just to figure out how will our films. I had gone to Cannes, but I didn't, actually, I'd gone to Venice. I'd never been to Cannes before. I'd gone to Venice with Yellow Boots in 2010. And I didn't know how to operate at a film festival. So I had overprinted stationery. I literally had some of the amazing directors now in our industry pin up posters of our Yellow Boot and walk around Venice Film Festival, you know. Because mujhe wahan jaake pata chala ki mujhe ye hoarding khareedni padegi. You know, main to 200 poster yahan se print karke le gayi thi. And it was all like, you know, it was like my imagination ki film festival mein kya hoga. Kabhi gayi nahi thi. I had overprinted stationery, printed our visiting cards in the Yellow Boots, and I thought ki ab premiere ho gaya, to ab to film bik jayegi, you know, aur aisa hua nahi hamare sath. And then I straight walked up to Marco Muller, artistic director, and I said, sir, no one's buying my film. How? He said, you know, this is a market and there are sales agents and you need them on your movie before. I was like, aapne pehle nahi bataya mujhe. I said why but what I had so many questions and of course that access was beautiful to him, and you know, he was very, very kind and very generous. And he said, ye jo book hai na Venice ki, market book itni moti, iske andar saath हर कंट्री के लोग आए हुए हैं, सबका लिखा हुआ है. दीज आर द पीपल यू नीड टू नो एज अ पर्सन, यू नो, एंड यू नीड टू नो देम, एंड दैट इज योर नेटवर्क. एंड देन दोज पीपल नीड टू सी योर फिल्म एटलीस्ट 2 months बिफोर. यू नीड टू हैव अ पीआर 2 months बिफोर. यू कांट, एंड यू नीड टू कम टू अ फिल्म फेस्टिवल, बिकॉज़ एक फिल्म फेस्टिवल में 200-300 फिल्में हैं ना. सो यू नीड टू कम टू दैट फिल्म फेस्टिवल फुल्ली प्रिपेयर्ड विद योर टीम, विद योर मीटिंग्स प्री लाइंड अप. आई वाज लाइक, ओ वाओ. I, after that information, I did not get out of the room in Venice. And I was only writing emails, ki koi to mil lo mere se. So, ab wo book mein se, you know, like, meet me, I want to talk to you about my film is premiered, meet me. And a lot of people replied, a lot of people did not reply. Mera Gmail block ho gaya tha, kyunki Gmail thought that I'm spamming.
Mails bhej diye the.
Nahi, itni mails bhej diye the. Aur plus, mere, because mujhe itni badi book cover karni thi, maine 4-5 logon ko apna Gmail khol ke de diya tha, mujhe sab bhejo. You know, so... भाई एक इंसान इतनी भेज सकता है ना एक दिन में. तो उसके बाद आई वॉज इन अ मिशन फॉर 1.5 ईयर ऑफ नोइंग ऑल दीज पीपल. एंड व्हेन आई टुक दैट बुक एंड आई इंटरनलाइज्ड दैट मार्केट गाइड वाज माय बाइबल, आई इंटरनलाइज्ड दैट बाइबल. आई रियलाइज लार्ज पार्ट ऑफ दीज पीपल आर इन फ्रांस, सम पार्ट आर इन लंडन, सम आर इन कोरिया, सम आर इन न्यूयॉर्क, सम आर इन एलए. एंड आई स्पेंट द नेक्स्ट 5 years actually going to all these 4 places, besides Korea. But Korea I went, but I stayed there for 1-2 weeks. But France, Paris, New York, London, LA, I used to stay for 1 month, 2 months, like couch surfing, staying on people's couches, making friends, staying in people's houses, sharing, taking, like, I don't know, 100-hour flights to America and 40-hour flights to Europe. And that's where I built a network. I started meeting people in their office and not expect to meet them at a film festival. Then I met them again at a film festival. And that built a network, a credibility, a conversation. So I was literally a foot soldier. I had researched and gotten a pen drive, which is pe likha tha Anurag Kashyap Films or mera email ID. Pirate. All Anurag. Put all our movies in it, in a pen drive. And we then hand gave this pen drive to everybody. You know, and at a point of time at a festival, it was so widely available that I'd gotten this made from China, exported them, researched. So, you know, just creative ways of hustle. And I think when I look back, I being in France, I understood that there were parallel sections like Director's Fortnight and Critics Week. I was able to then, you know, present my movie and apply for my movie, and very grateful that it got selected. I was able to call my producing partner to France and say, hey, let's, you know, make this meeting happen. So, you know that, and then once it got selected, because I was still in Paris, I was able to close a sales agent. I was able to, so, you know, one step at a time, one foot at a time, kept informing me and I kept pushing forward. And of course, learned a lot about international co-production, and then got these scholarships. I was being recommended by people, and then started thinking, diving down on how does this treaty work, and found my co-producers in France and Germany and structured Lunchbox, which I'm very, very proud of being a lead producer.
So are we. But Kuneet, you know, I'll tell you another thing. And the reason I want to go back to this is because of the fact that literally anything that is done, because there's such a, you know, every time you think about film festivals, you think of travel to Germany and France and this, that, and the other. It sounds very exciting. And it is, you know, it depends on what you find exciting, because it's not as if you're sitting on the, you know, sunning yourself on the Riviera. But the thing is that it also needs to be de-glamorized. Like, a lot of people come to me and they're like, we want to curate. And I'm like, matlab kaise? Like, how will this happen?
I have seen you and Anu slum it out. And you guys have seen me being going crazy, just trying to match one meeting after another. It is so hard. It is so hard. It is so expensive.
Hard that you like. See, my point is that what one wants to really reiterate is that it is very hard, but it's the hard that you enjoy. And therefore, just because there's joy in it, it doesn't mean that it is not hard as nails, right? Really? Like, every time Kalpana and I go, like, can be to hume PTSD ho jata hai ki, you know, abhi hum jayenge, abhi walk karna padega Riviera mein, aur aadhe se zyada log aapse milna nahi chahte, you know, so you're like the lowest priority in that ecosystem. So therefore, very important for me to ask you, because I sometimes see the word getting misinterpreted by a lot of people. When we say hustle, you know, it sounds very badass and it sounds very swaggy. But what exactly is hustle according to you, and how do you inform your hustle? How do you make that strong?
I think the power of showing up. You know, hustle is a huge sense of responsibility that you take ownership for something. It is your problem. You know, if this film has to get funded, if this film has to have a festival trajectory, you know, you have to inform yourself ki mere pure saal ki festival trajectory kya hai, main kahan se start kar rahi hu, uske baad kahan apply kar rahi hu. You know, you just can't think about one thing at a time. And this thought starts at the start of the film. You know, we are shooting our film at this point of time. हम लोग अब खत्म कर रहे हैं, हम लोग अब अपना रफ कट रेडी कर रहे हैं, हम किसको किसको दिखाना शुरू कर रहे हैं, हम कैसे अपना फीडबैक प्रोसेस कर रहे हैं, हम कैसे इस पर एक सॉफ्ट कॉन्वर्सेशन बिल्ड कर रहे हैं ऑफ पीपल फ्रेंड्स ऑफ द फिल्म, यू नो, फ्रेंड्स ऑफ दिस कॉन्वर्सेशन. सो इट इज़ अ लॉट ऑफ स्ट्रैटेजी, इट इज़ अ लॉट ऑफ राइटिंग, जेन्युइनली शोइंग अप, राइटिंग ईमेल्स, इन्वेंटिंग अ पाथ एवरी टाइम. देर इज़ नो क्लियर पाथ. You know, it is building a vision with every piece of content. It's been building a vision and then living under the burden of that vision, because I feel I could do better. You know, I genuinely feel, I in my gut genuinely feel that I am maybe two or three steps away from anybody in the world. You know, for me, it's not 7 degrees of separation. But I've built my hustle like that, that who's the one person I can write, can introduce me to that person, and will that person do? Then what do I need to do to be able to, you know, speak their language? So when you deal with US, when you deal with France, they speak a separate language of, you know, content of, there is an agent, there is an assistant, there is an agent, there is a manager, there is a lawyer, and then there is the producer. You know, so one needs to understand that and inform yourself on how, like, people, things that work there on landline, things that, like, Friday onwards, Europe doesn't work, you know, and then they open on Monday. You can't expect them to meet on Friday. So you need to plan your life like that. By 5 p.m. onwards, nobody meets you in LA. So you are in Cannes. How are these meetings being set up? You know, where are you sitting and what are you talking about and who are you meeting? What are their agendas? What are, follow-up is a huge deal. People handshake a lot. Nobody follows up. Nobody comes through. It takes us all behind, you know, like all those need to be done. Then everything needs to be followed up with calls, with scripts read, with, so that's informed my, I came from, you know, being in love with 90s cinema and I have grown to understand what this is. I think I'm somewhere a seeker of the business of movies around the world. So I seek it so much that I still follow those magazines. I still follow the business. I still follow Deadline, Hollywood Reporter, Variety, of course, but you know, a lot more knowing which deal is happening, what studio is buying, what is it. And when you go to a festival, you inform yourself. Like for me, it's priority to be a part of MAMI. It's priority to be there, attend, because it is what informs me ki dunya mein kya ho raha hai. You know, what are the kind of movies that people are liking? You know, there are, what is the, and it is a learning. There's not so much I can watch, but there's so much I can meet. I remember going to Cannes with films, and all my directors would be like coming back so happy saying, aaj humne teen picture dekhi. And I used to be like, aaj main 6 logon se mili. You know, I had never had the luxury to watch a movie at a festival because I was always like, I need to meet them and that's what I need to do. So I used to also get guilt, ki are, matlab, but that is my work.
Yes.
So Cannes, Venice, Toronto, Film Bazaar, MAMI, our work hours for a producer. They're not at any iota of luxury or a holiday. You know, they're so intense. They're so power-packed. Like, puri dunya aa rahi hai, ye 5 din, and they're ready to talk to you. How many people can you talk to? And then how many people out of them, I had made like my own thing, ki achha agar can mein 10,000 log aa rahe hain, inme se shayad 1,000 log interested bhi honge India mein, unme se shayad 200 log will want to do business, maybe have stories, and then how do I meet them? You know, and how do I get in ahead of them? So a sort of strategy, like ye India section hai, yahan par maybe my card should be there. You know, so I used to keep strategizing on how do I get ahead? How do I get to know people? But I think going to people's offices, traveling, and then doing follow-up meetings at festivals, what really also helped that my journey at AKFPL, we every year had a film selected at a festival. So that informed and amplified my hustle, you know, and I was able to ask more questions, do more, meet more. I went from meeting and making friends with sales agents to now meeting distributors.
Yeah.
And now knowing
moving up
to every country, you know, and then seeing how their business models work, you know, and then being curious about, acha aap Japan mein kaise karte ho release, aap Netherlands mein kaise karte ho release, aap and aap kitne screens karte ho wahan par, kya business hai. So that kind of curiosity, that kind of again, there's no other word than hustle, you know, because actually largely what hustle is, that you go, you're walking in a dense fog, okay, and you're running, right? And you're hitting arrows. Ki kuch to lagega, kuch to dart par lagega. And it is exhausting, it is brain exhausting. But then actually kuch lag jata hai, you know, and that is the beauty of hustle and intent, that you're so sincerely pushing for it, that, you know, that people inform you to more people inform you to more people, and there is a way of doing this. You know, if you know, like I know one producer in Luxembourg, or I know one producer in Azerbaijan, you know, and that is my peer group. If there is anything I ever, and not that will translate into money and business tomorrow morning, but even if I'm 60 years old, I know if I need to do something in Azerbaijan or co-production or something, I know who to call. And
at least you can get a drink in Azerbaijan, if nothing else.
I will even get stay anywhere around the world. So my house is like a traveler's home because the whole world has extended their homes to me. You know, when I've been a young hustler, producer, putting 5 stories, making my presentations on laptop, then on iPad, then on printouts, leaving it behind, you know, doing that kind of prep. My bags used to only be stationary when I used to travel. You know, matlab, you have to constantly see, matlab, mujhe to, how to, you know, use the train system in France, how to use the taxi system in LA. It's been like every little thing has been, I come from a very, very middle class family. I didn't travel as a child, but a very, very humble family. So all these were like, you know, how are you managing food between meetings? How are you scheduling, showing up? You cannot afford to be late. You have to be at your A game.
And also preparing a day before.
Who are these people? Who are you talking to? What are they?
Who am I talking to? So hustle actually is a lot of intelligent hard work.
It is. And we cut ourselves a lot of, you know, we're like, we cut ourselves a lot of, we don't give ourselves the credit of this intelligent hard work. And I love your words always. Like I remember when Gangs of Wasseypur happened, and it's a very interesting story. We really wanted to do US territory sale, and US territory sale did not happen. So, you know, I was able to come up with an idea of cutting it into 8-part series and selling it to Netflix for only US territory. So it was actually India's first 8-part mini series, you know. So Gangs of Wasseypur released in US via Netflix way before even they were doing international content, and they were doing some of it, and there was a window that we were able to do that. So it was just, you know, that is all that I was informed that there are 8-part mini series way back in 2012. And we made 40-minute or 8-part series of our 5.5-hour film. I was informed of that because I was able to travel to festivals, because I was able to learn from what is happening in the rest of the world. And then how is India positioned in the rest of the world? So, yeah.
Puneet, you know, which brings me to, I'm going to ask you 2 last questions before I open the house out to people who want to ask questions, because I want to take in as many questions as possible from them. But what I'm curious about is that, you know, you did all this laying down of the pipeline, you know, the first level experiences, going to festivals, navigating festivals, they are expensive. So, you know, prep is very important. We keep saying that at Mami as well. But I still, and I'm not saying people are ignorant. Maybe it's not actually available. I have a lot of interesting, very, very sincere filmmakers who get in touch with me and consistently ask me, who should we apply to? How do we apply? Sometimes, you know, because of lack of bandwidth, I also feel irritated. Then I calm down because I'm thinking in my head, ki yaar, website pe jaake dekh lo na, deadline kab hai. But then I don't want to do that because I know they're asking because they feel ki maybe they'll be told. They're not, maybe they're not lazy. They're just intimidated.
Nobody does.
I want to know ki kisi ko aisa kaise hai ki 10 saal ke baad bhi hume pata nahi hai. We don't have sales agents in India that represent Indian films. We don't have knowledge of how to navigate this world. A very, very close producer friend of mine who was dabbling with the idea of producing an independent film, which was very different, actually called me up and said that I love this script, I want to do this, but how do I recover the money? So shed a little bit of light on why this lack of knowledge, why this lack of not knowing what to do at what point of time in this world, in the independent industry.
I would say, you know, for me, I want to say that for all the young, super young people, I would say treat Mami as your Mecca in India. Because Bombay to aa sakte ho, Bombay mein to aake kahin se bhi aap chahe FTI SRFTI mein padh rahe ho, you know, prioritize being at Mami, because at least 10,000 people don't come there, but 2,000 people who are there are only interested, or 100 people that you bring down from outside India are only here in that week interested in you, interested in India, and that is precious. You know, this gets lost when you are at a Cannes or at a Venice, at a Toronto. you know, it's such a huge mass and they are interested in the whole world. That so firstly, treat a film festival here, and even when, you know, and you are inviting so many people. I have met people at MAMI which have uplifted, and I'm working with them now, you know. And those conversations were able to happen over drinks, and one of my biggest and the most precious connection in the whole world is because of you, is because of MAMI, which is Ava DuVernay.
Yes.
You know, we were able to have a dinner. We were able to schedule a dinner. Where on this earth would I imagine I would get to her and sit down and tell her my story? And that happened because of MAMI. You know, so super young, first time thinking about international, show up here. You know, volunteer, show up. Matlab, if you have to ask any questions, ask who are the people coming and how do I meet them? Because that is the threshold of starting point. So those are all the same people who are, you know, festival programmers. And festival programmers introduced me to more people. Then I was on panels and then stayed in touch, you know, apply for producer Breakfast Lab at Cannes. 200 people apply for that, you know. So that is your first, that's your peer group. Set up meetings from there. Mentors will come and teach you. Apply for producing labs around the world. There are short labs. There are online labs by Sundance. You know, so all this, that's where you get all the knowledge, you know, or you are a USC, NYU student. They give you all this knowledge. What are the film festivals or any university around the world? So if you're not studying producing, then apply for producing workshops. I still apply for them.
Yes.
And I recently was having a conversation with Film Independent and I was like, I want to learn.
Exactly.
I was a fellow last year. In fact, I won a grant there. I won the Sloan grant in 2019. I applied with my project, you know, and one has to be that. You cannot sit and say, I don't know, because it is your job to know.
Also, follow festivals, like we just, Guneet, you were also part of that, you know, Mativanan and, you know, Celine, they started Producer Land.
Yeah.
They didn't go out.
Producer's Land, and it is much, much needed, you know, and that's where I think an ecosystem will be built here. You know, there'll be younger producers sharing knowledge. So ask these knowledges, you know, and it's very important to research, to be online. You know, 2010, I had a short film that was nominated for an Oscar. I had just come off a huge personal tragedy, and I had no money, and no visa, no American visa. Kabhi gaye nahi hai, pata nahi hai, kaise hoga.
Shiv was the short film, right?
Kavi was the short film, and it won the student Oscar, and it then came into 2010 Oscars. And this one, and Sagar Salunke, lovely actor, lovely boy. Now he works with Shlok in production. He's amazing. So I didn't know, it was 2010, you know. All I did was write emails all day to EAs of rich people who I thought could give me financing to land up in LA. And for me, rich people were Richard Branson, Ratan Tata, like by the book rich people, not just anyone.
Not just random rich. You went for the noted rich.
Yeah, because that's all I knew, ki ye log mujhe shayad grant de denge. You know, I wrote so many emails that at the end of the day, I wrote to the president of India and I was able to get a grant and I was able to show up in LA and attend the Oscars, and that was my only dream. You know, so how did that happen? Like this is hustle.
Also, Guneet, another thing that brings me to, like, we get a lot of letters, right? I think just very briefly shed light on when you're reaching out to people, you know, you can have a very impassioned plea, but when you're reaching out to people, you need to reach out to people with a plan, right? Like sometimes I get emails which literally are, you know, it cannot be, how should I put it? It cannot be just a plea for mercy.
No, you need to make plans. We are in the business of filmmaking. You can't sit and just say that I'm doing art. You're in the business of filmmaking and you need to talk that language. You need to talk the same language that people understand. So every film is like you need to make your revenue sheet, which is low, medium and high. You know, agar aapne achhi picture bana li, to aap agar high pe hit karo, and you need to set up examples. So there is a business plan to films. Every film is like setting up a company and you're the CEO of the company. So if I'm asking you today that I need 100 rupees from you, आई नीड टू टेल यू दैट बिकॉज उस फिल्म का इतना था, उस फिल्म का इतना था, उस फिल्म का इतना था, ऐसे 5-7 एग्जाम्पल्स है मेरे पास, क्योंकि इस एक्टर ने इतना काम किया है, ये ऐसे हुआ है. आई थिंक अगर मेरी पिक्चर बिल्कुल नहीं चली तो हम लोग तब भी 85 कमा लेंगे, अगर हमारी बहुत चल गई तो हम 200 कमा लेंगे, और अगर ठीक ठाक चल गई तो हम 150 कमा लेंगे. देन इट इज योर कॉल टू टेल मी, अच्छा आई विल गिव यू 20 रुपीज और आई गिव यू 100 रुपीज.
Exactly.
बट आई हैव मेड दिस बिजनेस प्लान फॉर एवरी फिल्म ऑफ माइन एंड देयर आर 40 ऑफ देम, एंड उसके अलावा और 40 थी जो बनी नहीं, यू नो, बट यू हैव टू डू दैट वर्क एवरी डे
एंड गो टू समबडी विद अ प्लान so that they can, they have all the information, they know that you're a serious person, you're an intelligent person, you've come with a proposal and can now weigh in on that.
Basic.
Guneet, also, I mean, I can speak to you the whole day on this because you're a storehouse of knowledge, also because you've done the groundwork, Guneet. I think there is something to be said about foot soldiers, that when you are a foot soldier and you lay out that pipeline yourself and you start to grow, there is a different kind of knowledge that you have, which cannot be, encapsulated very quickly because it's experiential knowledge, which is just, outstanding. Somebody, Swati Chugh, actually, who's a filmmaker, came up. I mean, she's written on YouTube, and I hope you find the time to do this. We would love to collaborate with you because I've wanted to do this forever, but she's actually said that Guneet should write a book on beginner's guide to being an independent producer. Guneet, you should really consider that. I promise you, I'll help you.
If I love your words, Smriti. If I, you and I have had this conversation, if you're willing to write it with me,
let's do this.
I'm happy to sign up. I know that there are many talks out there. In fact, each of my films can be a case study, because the reason we crowdfunded Peddlers and Haramkhor, because we knew we were doing something experimental and we didn't want to only go to equity money, which has the pressure of recovery, so we diversified our risk, and that's why we raised money, and it was way ahead. There were no co-production markets. There was no crowdfunding platforms, and I did it on my Facebook. But the ideas also came because I've seen people do this in the West. And I studied about them, and I was like, okay, friends and family से थोड़े थोड़े पैसे मांग लेते हैं, diversify कर लेते हैं, और उनको पहले से बोल देते हैं, हम कुछ कर रहे हैं, हम शायद पैसे वापस कम आए, but you're aware, I'm not doing false promises, I'm not, so that's why there was no pressure on them, and we are still working on them. When the Lunchbox and Monsoon Shootout and Masaan happened, there were very conscious calls to do co-productions, and why they were conscious calls, because when we did those script labs, we realized that there is people here love it, and there's a market for it. And we started building our revenue sheets around that. We started building our revenue plans with films like that, and informing myself, like, what are my kinds of films, Asian films that are South Asian films that have done what kind of business, then which film, which distributor bought, which are the top three distributors in every country in the whole world, then can I reach out to them? I had my meetings lined up with them before the film premiered. I had saved seats for them to go see my film. So that kind of work you need to do, you are one amongst 300, 500 films in a festival, and how do you break out of those? Firstly, it's amazing that you've gotten there. You're amongst the best in the world. You're at par. But now the work of a producer actually starts from the moment you've got that letter that you are selected. And it's literally 2 months from your PR. For Gangs of Wasseypur, for Lunchbox, we had, for Peddlers, we had a Cannes PR, we had a global PR, we had an India PR. And we had built conversations, so we had built, and those meetings were set up from before, so that is, it does not happen on its own.
And we've screened so many of your films, Haramkhor,
Haramkhor, nobody actually, again, each of these films is like a journey. Haramkhor actually was a film that nobody wanted to buy, and I remember people coming to my office. मैंने कम से कम 200-300 लोगों को दिखाया होगा, एवरी पॉसिबल डिस्ट्रीब्यूटर इन इंडिया, लाइक, अरे नवाज की फिल्म, अरे सिर्फ क्राउड फंडिंग से बनी है, तो ये तो ले लेनी चाहिए. बट लोग पिक्चर देखते थे और कहते थे, ये क्या है, ये तो हम ले नहीं सकते. एंड देन मामी हैपेंड, एंड थैंक गॉड फॉर मामी. वी नॉट ओनली वेंट एंड वन वन ऑफ द बिग अवार्ड्स एट मामी, बट द फर्स्ट टाइम देयर वाज अ कम्युनिटी स्क्रीनिंग ऑफ द फिल्म, एंड द फिल्म ब्रोक आउट एट अ फेस्टिवल. People were talking about it in streets, and the joy of that, from not being heard, of living with under expression, to finding love, to people talking about it, to people saying ek aur screening kara do, to winning an award And that money helped us finish the film. That money helped us do our PNA for the film. And it released in cinemas. You know, so it is the power of curation, power of a film festival. So, and then of course, having a PR, having this mechanism of building conversations. So any film festival that you go to, you need that kind of, and then I didn't know enough when I was doing this that, you know, I need to budget for them. So it was always becoming a stretch. It was always becoming ki ab to humne apni picture bana li, ab iske kahan se. So now be aware, day one say, if you are on an independent journey, budget for this, you know, raise it in advance because you need to do that. So yeah.
Guneet, last question before we get on to everybody's very exciting questions coming in. And I want to know what are the different ways. And of course, briefly, because I know you can give a 7-hour masterclass on this because it's a separate topic altogether. What are the ways in which, like if you are thinking about an independent project and you know that your traditional release in India might not be possible for many reasons, you know, censorships, PNA, whatever. But if you're embarking on a project like that, what are the revenue sources available to you in the international arena as well as in India? This is a very big question.
The world has changed. The world has evolved from 2010, 2012 to now. And so has my journey and so has Sikha and so has, you know, the world is now informed, is evolved to global buyers like Netflix and Amazon. You know, your global deals happen with global footprint with Disney and with, you know, and I have also moved to being in a place of trying to do this through a certain route. I think a lot. I actually now feel like every film has a different journey. And as a producer, you need to see that what is, so when like for Paglet or like for Surya Rai Potru or like for, somebody has asked for Zindagi in Short Question. You know, my market is India and the way we dealt with, so you have theatrical, you have digital, you have music, you have airline, you have, you know, all these satellite rights. So you have a revenue sheet of all these breakup. When you go internationally, previously how it used to happen, you used to have per country sales agent used to give you per country MGs, lesser, low, minimum, high. And then getting a sales agent was a big deal. Now that has evolved into being more dynamic because now there are global buyers, you know, like Apple, HBO, Disney.
MG is minimum guarantee.
MG is minimum guarantee. Yeah. So, you know, it is, now I feel like even my own journey has evolved. And I mean, from, like you said, indie to epic, even my own journey has evolved where I did all of that because at that point of time, having less access, how does that door open? You know, the door that you have to break through and you have to open. Now that I understand that the door has opened a bit for me, I'm also scaling up. I'm also doing bigger work, which has bigger actors, which has which is interacting with the current business and allows current business to participate. I was working on the periphery of the business because I didn't have an in, you know, and that is the only thing that I could do. And I did that for a very long time. And that's what informed me to do international co-productions. Now my way of looking at international co-productions is also evolved because I'll be able to cast bigger and I'll be able to bring bigger money from India. And not being in a position of only dependent outside. So that is a transition that I've been able to make in my career and in my storytelling. So now I can sit back and inform myself that this is the best of international, that I can add that as a value to a movie that I'm a part of. And this is the best of India, that I know that these are few people I can partner with, like when we did Bittu, to have Tyra and have Ekta, to build a larger conversation with Indian women rising. It's not something that it could happen overnight because there is 10 years of work on it. Because there is so much 10 years of work on it that I was able to inform and move quickly to support a movie. And not only a movie, but start a collective where we want to support more. And it's a conversation that I will have with you. But, you know, so what I'm trying to say here is that that the revenue streams, I mean, this is just very easy to understand and know. The revenue streams are simple. It's theatrical, digital, satellite, music, and then airline, and then any other further syndications, mobile rights. Largely it is this. Theatrical is your factor where you have to, where it can be super mega hit. Again, nobody planned for a pandemic globally. So now this model can be either per country wise, or it can be summed up and done at a global level. But which is that piece of content that is even worth going per country wise? You know, not everything translates, not everything travels.
How do you take that call, Gunit?
That call is with the story. You know that the story has an emotional resonance or no or not, you know. And what are the choices that you are telling? Is it an expositional choice of telling that story, or is it a held back choice of telling that story? You know, so when I choose a piece of content, it informs me with the story, and with the maker, with the filmmaker. So it's a deep understanding ki ye kaise dikhega. And once we both see the same thing, then I know that ye aur hum kiske saath share kar sakte hain, you know. And at the end of the day, we are what our exposure is. We are what our taste is, you know. And that kind of matches with people globally. And you know that, okay, this is something that this one will like. This is something that one will like, you know. So, and that is now producing Hustle for me. So it's no more foot soldier journey for me. Now it is strategy. Now it is all the people I know are also doing amazingly well globally and in India. So it's more like the piece of content that I'm a part of now. I know that where I need to know for myself, what is it that, how am I adding value to this? Why am I picking this up? And where am I going to take this? You know, and what will be the impact of this? So all these decisions are related as we move forward in Sikhya. And across, now that we are in 5 divisions, we are doing so much nonfiction after period end of sentence that activated. We are doing podcasts, we are doing short content, we are doing web series, we are doing films. The hustle is increased to a little village.
No, but it's also, it is also you using the success that you've had and the experience to bridge that gap between Indian epic, as we've called it, but like you've termed it, Gunit, that it's the new commercial. Because the thing is, when you do get certain commercial elements like bigger actors, you know, bigger artists or more saleable artists or more skilled artists to tell a certain kind of story, the reach increases. It's a fact. And you've begun to do that. You've begun to play that game. So it's a wonderful case study. I wish I had more time with you, but I'm going to ask everyone to put on their cameras so that they get an opportunity to speak to you now, Gunit. Yes. They've been waiting for a while I jabber. So let's have everyone on. Thank you guys for joining us at a time like this. I'm going to request Digonta De to put on his, to be unmuted, please. I was so busy trying to get his name right.
Hi guys, thank you for showing up today.
Can we unmute Digonta, please? I think my team also can't. Digonta ko unmute kar do yaar.
Yeah. I am trying a lot.
Yeah, yeah, poor thing.
From my side.
I think I Komal sent me the pronunciation and I went to that and they were like, who's Digonta?
It's a kind of a tough Bengali name for everyone to pronounce. So I call it a day. If you have facing any issues, call me in my last name.
Go for it. Please ask me.
So yeah, my question is to Gunit. So there's a two simple questions. So I'm an independent filmmaker and producer. So I'm working on my debut feature. So I'm facing a lot of issues in co-production market application. What I have faced in few co-production markets, they are just telling this, that if you are applying for this lab or apply for the co-production market, then you have to be a producer attached from this country. Like if I have applied for a France, any grant or like that, or any co-production market, then I have to be a producer attached from France. So in this early stage, there's a kind of a impossible for a lot of us as an in this early stage. So how you overcome with this problem? Because right now it is. And there's a second question. is regarding a sales agent. So I was attended Platform Busan in Busan International Film Festival on 2019 in the Asian film market. So just you said that your mail got stuck, and myself was also, because I was participated with my a short film project like that. So on that time I faced this, options of sales agents is so much optionable for like European countries and for Asian, like so much Korean and Japanese, for Korea and Japan, but not for India. So what I faced personally. So this is the two questions for you. How you overcome with these problems? Because this is kind of a problem for a lot of us, I think. Thank you.
So thank you, Diganda. I applied to Berlin co-production market, which did not have this thing. I have applied to Cinemart, which did not have that you need a producer from here. Also, Torino, I have worked with, they did not have that. I worked with Sundance, IFP, they did not, Sundance is in Utah, IFP was in New York, they did not have this. Co-production market in Toronto did not have this. I don't know which co-production market in France you're saying, but if it is Rotterdam, which might have that you need a Netherlands producer. But that is only for Hubert Ball's fund and other kind of funds. But co-production market, you need to have your own producer, and you need to be able to do that. Somebody who's ready to. One has to understand that what is very tough for us here is that people are used to having producers around the world, used to having creative independent producers, and the business works producer first outside India. In India, it is very director-led or very actor-led, So people don't know how to place a director, People know how to place a producer. And business there is first, producer first, So the lack of producers in India does complicate the scenario globally, because there are just so many producers there, and it works in a certain way. So if all directors are producers, then it is just challenging for them to bifurcate, is what I understand. So I don't know which market you're talking about, but I never faced that problem. I've done co-production market even in Dubai. I don't know if Dubai Film Festival happens anymore, but even in Dubai, I did co-production market. I didn't have this kind of problems. Then the other question was Busan. I didn't really understand the question, that there is lack of support for India and for other Asian countries. What was the question again?
Can we unmute Diganta again, please?
Yeah, so actually my question is regarding the sales agent. So the sales agent, the entire idea is, I faced, it's a very much European or like American formula. So in this Indian scenario, so what I have faced that I participated with one of my project. So, few of them also, but who are actually from the European side, they are getting easily the, sales agents from, different, I don't tell the names, but for participants like us, what I have faced is that, actually we have not so much, lined up structured regarding the sales agent. Right now, I don't know, but
I'll tell you. That's also because it's very deep-rooted problem, and I actually went into I went into a big depression after Lunchbox because of lack of ecosystem in India, So I was out of the business 2014, 15, 16. It was very, very hard on me personally because I went through the sales agent model and that ecosystem does not exist in India. So here what happens is that you have to sell your content worldwide to Indian players, like Indian satellite TV. Even before Netflix and Amazon was here, you have to sell worldwide rights to Indian TV studios. You have to Zee, to Star, to whoever. And that cuts your wings and legs, hands and legs to sell outside India. Whereas everywhere outside the India, it is territory-wise sale. It is normal for people to say domestic sale, which is their personal country, and then international. So even if it's the biggest studios in US, it's all about domestic and rest of the world. Whereas in India, it is all about everything. India plus rest of the world is one. So when your buyer is one, how will you ever engage with other buyers? And then how will our cinema ever increase? And then why will a sales agent be interested there? That is why there is no ecosystem of sales agents in India. So while I tried that, it was so isolating, you know, the burden of being the first one, that I was misunderstood by my India equity players and my partners in India, because it was more like, "Arey, we have, you know, we went against the system." But Lunchbox became what it became because I was able to break that system and allow 100 buyers to be a part of that project without knowing that this will result into money or not. You know, it was like, "Acha, ab le lo territory." अब उस टेरिटरी से तो हमें तो थोड़ा थोड़ा एमजी मिल रहा था, 10-20-50 हजार डॉलर एवरी टेरिटरी अराउंड द वर्ल्ड, बट इट वाज नॉट वन चंक ऑफ मनी दैट यू गेट इन इंडिया. एंड दैट इज हाउ एंड दैट इज व्हाई आई फील देर इज अ लैक ऑफ सेल्स एजेंट्स, देर इज अ लैक ऑफ बिजनेस, बिकॉज देर इज नो इकोसिस्टम दैट एग्जिस्ट राइट नाउ. एंड इट इज चेंजिंग विद नाउ ग्लोबल बायर्स हैपनिंग. आई थिंक नाउ इवन सम शिफ्ट नीड्स टू हैपन, where you think that how do I work with global buyers and break out on their platforms? You know, the different kind of breakout needs to happen now. So don't be discouraged by that. It is more like, how do you pave your way through it? And the paving your way through it would be to do co-productions and to have producers from other parts of the world who can activate a sales agent for you in case your film needs it. Yeah.
Thank you. Can we unmute Arkapol Chaudhary, please?
Was I clear, guys? Just say this.
Yes. We'll wait for that book also, I just want to say. Arko, go for it. Hi, hope you're good.
Hi, I'm well. Thanks, Kriti. And thanks, Guneet, for the conversation so far. Guneet, my question is about the state of censorship on content in the country right now. There are various forces at work where, you know, either some people take offense, something lands up in court, or there are some curbs put on content and the streaming platforms have no option but to comply. How do you not let all this affect you, and how do you sort of retain your creative vision and, you know, make sure that you are able to tell a story exactly the way you want to say it?
Yeah, I think it's a good question. I have been at a place where I have, you know, been, honestly, I've been at a place where I've judged the system very long. I've just felt misunderstood. I felt like, oh my God, you know, how will this ever happen? You know, and the break that I took for 2-3 years and the 2.0 version of Sikha and Me, I want to be a part of the system. I want to very much thrive what the world has to offer and make it work. It actually pushes me to even be even more intelligent in telling the story and retaining our vision and continue pushing for it, not with an agenda, but with holding hands of everyone and still being able to tell. Like if you look at, I mean, Iranian cinema, if you look at cinema around the world, which is, you know, far more, or Arabic, which is far more censorized and far more crazy. There are journalists telling their pieces. There are amazing filmmakers telling their pieces. So it's almost like, how do you work around it? What, I mean, now that is the deck that is offered to you. Make the best out of it.
Yeah. Thank you. Can we unmute Tapas Bhadra, please? Yeah, there you go, Tapas, go for it.
Thank you. Hi, Kuni. So thank you for this discussion and conversation about and telling us a story. So my question to you is, so basically your films have always gone beyond boundaries and audience expectations story-wise, if you see Gangs of Wasseypur or The Lunchbox. So my question is, how do you decide that the audience is ready for a particular type of film or story if something similar to that has never been made in our country? How are you so sure? What analysis do you do, or the research that goes behind it? Yeah,
you know, like I said, our exposure informs us. you know, I think because I've traveled, because I've seen, because I've interacted with filmmakers around the world, it allows me to inform my decision. Our exposure and our taste is who we are, you know, and it, and you have to work on it every day. I mean, it's like boyhood and I could not sleep for days. I was like, holy shit. I've been 12 socha hai, roz shoot kiya hai, matlab har saal shoot kiya hai with the same actors. How did somebody even think of it, you know? And if somebody can think about it, you know, what are we doing? Is there somebody here doing this? I mean, you know, your exposure. I mean, you see work and you're just like, holy shit, how did they do it? And you then were like, I remember seeing Boyhood and not being able to sleep for straight days. Like, I was just pacing up and down. I just was like, kaise socha ye? Kaise? Kaise? You know, kisne socha? So I think that happens, you know. You get inspired. You build your gut instinct. I would say, follow your gut instinct. Build it, you know, make mistakes. Come through those mistakes. Show up after those mistakes. You know, so not that everything I've done has hit the jackpot in every which way, but we try. And yes, it, and content is subjective, you know, and understand that what the journeys that we are on is subjective. Anything that I'm doing now, I think you all will see it in 2023, but I wake up so excited about it every day. I was like, ek din ye bahar aayega, but what 2023 mein aayega, you know, but I'm already so excited about it. Now it has to be relevant in 2023, you know. But that is the journey we are on.
Can we unmute Dhruv Suri, please? Hi, Dhruv, go for it.
Hello. Hey. Hi. My internet connection is a little bit unstable, so I might drop in and out. I just wanted to say thank you to Guneet for taking the time, and thank you to Mami as usual for putting all this together. So my question is, what advice would you give Guneet to writer directors who are outsiders in the industry, who are looking to get their debut projects in front of the right producer? So apart from hanging out at food courts and hoping that somebody has 50 lakhs, what else can we do to get the projects considered by the right producer for the job?
So yeah, I think that's what I do when I build my co-production. Work on the material, have your one-line synopsis, have your pitch. Like I said in the session, literally Lunchbox pitch was rehearsed. We rehearsed, Ritesh and I rehearsed our jokes. We rehearsed our, you know, who will say which line. Puri raat we used to rehearse, because agle din we had to do that. You know, there are 8 million dabba walas in, and this system, Harvard has done a study, 99.9% of the time they're perfect, but what if that 1%? And then he used to say something and I used to say something and then we used to laugh, you know. So we've rehearsed this. What I'm trying to tell you, the work that goes behind this, you know, and then we have corrected each other's lines. And how do we also get a producer interested? It's work that needs to be put in, you know, and your log line, your elevator pitch, your bigger pitch, your synopsis, even if you're reaching out to us at Sikya, you know, we revert in 3 weeks. We have an email ID, we have a website, you can apply, but just be clear with your synopsis. I get scripts on my WhatsApp. Those people are blocked. You know, so don't do that. You know, so just don't send scripts, synopsis to people on WhatsApp because you found a number. Write an amazing email. Write a good email. Say that, you know, I'd love to meet. This is my synopsis. This is my log line. Do you think you'd like to meet? Just, and people respond. People respond globally. We respond at Sikya. So...
thank you, Guni. Yeah. I keep on thinking Anikhet Roomde is flying a helicopter while he's attending the session because of the headphones.
I was thinking that. It's like he's
I thought he's he's on to something definitely. But Anikhet, we'll come to you. But can we unmute Siddharth Menon, please? Siddharth, go for it.
Hi, thank you, Smriti. Again, the entire team, always.
Siddharth, quickly ask your question. Lots of questions are left. Siddharth's a regular DILM participant, so now we've become friends with him virtually. Like, it's go for it. Go home now. Go.
Which was your favorite session, Siddharth? I'm getting competitive.
List your top five.
So I'll first of all, congratulations on the French Honor Civilian
Award. Thank you.
And so I happened to watch an interview of yours and a panel of others, including Mr. Anurag Kashyap with Film Companion, which you did about the film exhibition and film distribution around last year. In that, Mr. Anurag was saying a specific aspect that, you know, there aren't just enough spaces and screens at all in the first place. And so the fight as such is not only ideological, it's also the fact that there is not even that many screens available to showcase the films that we want. Now, in such, and then he cited examples of Anarkali of Ara and Yesterday the Girl in Yellow Boots. Now, I wanted to understand, with so many challenges in place, how do you ensure to, like, you know, keep yourself motivated in terms of, you know, the content that you want to push out, and not only from the script and story wise, but also, like you said, it's show business. It's not just intellectual. There is also a cost factor to it. So how do you try to keep yourself, like, on the go now? And has it changed with the advent of OTT? So that's the question.
Has it changed?
Hello?
What was the last thing? Has it changed?
Has it changed with the advent of OTT, with OTT coming?
No, so I think at the core of it, you know, challenges are everywhere, you know, in European countries where you're writing applications and not getting heard and you're going through bureaucracy to make a film. They think it is so cool that you can make films through equity here, you know. Here we think, oh my God, nobody's giving money because, you know, they are judging us. So I think you're dealt different cards everywhere, guys, you know. So I had to define success for myself, irrespective of everything. And for me, my definition of success is that if I show up inspired every morning, I'm successful. Because you need to be inspired to do what we do. And that inspiration comes from stories. That inspiration comes from people. That inspiration comes from people you're surrounded with, you know? And if you can just do that every morning and you can continue to own that journey, you know, it'll be beautiful. So I feel if my team shows up inspired every morning, we are all extremely successful. We are moving forward. Har roz aisa lagta hai ki aaj to kuch nahi hua, aaj email likha jawab bhi nahi aaya, you know. But at the end of the decade, I feel like I've done all of this. I've been there, you know. And at the end of the decade, I really feel like I used to think that I could not move a rock. I feel like I've moved a mountain, you know. And now it is about what else, like what can I do? What can we do? And everything, every piece of campaign, every piece of not only making the film, you know, putting it out, releasing, marketing it in the US, marketing it during Oscars, marketing it during Cannes, marketing it during Mami, marketing it during Toronto. It's a piece of work. It's a lot of work, you know, and then you want to do the best, like, sabse achha kahan se kaise hua tha? Do you know what are the strategies being employed for films that are, you know, right now at the Academy Awards, or our 30th April is the last deadline of Cannes. You know, what are the conversations? So just knowing these deadlines, just knowing what are we putting out there, what are we doing? So being on top of it, you know, and then hoping, you know, you never know where what will hit. When we were doing Period End of Sentence, we didn't think we will win the Oscar. You know, when we were doing Kavi, we didn't think we will be winning the student Oscar and being nominated in top five, or with Masaan that it or Lunchbox will win the awards or will become a global hit. You just show up every morning, do your best, and just know that I did my best despite people judging, despite people telling you that this will not work, despite lack of cinemas, despite lack of money, despite lack of faith. You know, that faith from you, what has helped me is also my spiritual journey. I think we are all spiritual beings having human experiences. So some deep-rooted spiritual journey which has taken away my validation from people, you know, around, because we are in such a subjective industry. Our ideas are crushed. It feels like our babies are judged, you know. So, and I have said this before in my interviews, and I'll say it again. Very young, when I was very young and I turned 18, my dad asked me to become an insurance agent, you know, and he got me into an insurance agent because unko lagta tha ki meri koi fixed income ban jayegi aur wo apne doston ko life insurance bech denge. You know, unke dost older hai, he will sell it and I will mere naam par bech denge aur mujhe saal ke saal paisa aayega. That was his big business plan for me. Okay. And I went to Ritu Nanda school in Delhi and I studied insurance and I got a job at Tata AIG. Okay. And then my dad started selling insurance on my name. I was only excited about stationery at Tata AIG. You know, I was like, arey, itna achha achha paper mila. You know, colorful pen mile insurance likhne ke liye. But what I learned there, you know, was just the most beautiful thing that's always stayed with me. So imagine going to people and saying, guys, you're going to die. Why don't you save up some money with us for your family? Right? This is what I was selling at the crux of it. Ki aap marne wale ho, aap hume paise de do. तो फिर आपकी फैमिली का भला हो जाएगा क्योंकि हम पक्का उनको पैसे दे देंगे वापस डबल ट्रिपल करके. राइट. सो दे यूज्ड टू टेल मी दैट 10 पीपल विल से नो टू यू एंड देन 1 पर्सन विल से यस. सो दैट हैज स्टेड विद मी. सो नाउ व्हेन समबडी सेज नो, आई एक्चुअली गेट वेरी एक्साइटेड. आई एम लाइक वाह, आई एम गेटिंग क्लोजर टू माई नेक्स्ट, यू नो. सो एवरी टाइम आई एंटर अ रूम, आई एंटर विद दैट एनर्जी. इफ यू वॉन्ट टू से नो, से जस्ट से टूडे, जस्ट डोंट एक्सटेंड इट टू 2 months. You know, just don't extend the no to 1 month, 2 months. Just say it, aar paar karo na, because I know my 11th person is coming. I have to try and open this door 10 times. So that has kept me going, always. I've had so many no's, but I've been excited about every no. I've been like, holy shit, my yes is coming closer. I'm trying to use that in my personal life also, but professional life, it has worked.
Guneet, before we move on to the next person who's on Zoom with us, I want to take a question from YouTube. Sharmishta wants to know, is there a gender discrimination, caste discrimination in the business? How do you think in future Dalits, especially Dalit women entering, should protect and ally with? How should they protect themselves and who can they ally with?
You know, the universe that I inhabit, we don't have that lens of discrimination, you know. So I would say my office, people that we work with, I don't think I'm in a position to comment of industry at large, but the world that I have inhabited doesn't have caste discrimination. Gender, yes, there is a lens. There is definitely lack of opportunities, which so much data tells us. Film Companion did a case study. There is so much data that there is, that there has been gender discrimination. But I also think that I came into this industry with nothing and I've made some of the most amazing friends. I've been able to push through. I've been able to build a career. I've been able to build knowledge. It does matter with who you work with. And then that is open to every industry in the world, na? मतलब इफ यू आर इन मेडिकल, इफ यू आर इन इंजीनियरिंग, इफ यू आर इन कॉल सेंटर, दैट लेंस इज एवरीवेयर. बट आई थिंक आई एक्चुअली लव द बिजनेस. आई लव द गुड पार्ट ऑफ दिस बिजनेस. देर आर पीपल मिस यूजिंग देयर पोजिशन, देर आर पीपल मिस यूजिंग देयर पावर. इट्स ऑन यू टू कॉल इट आउट अर्ली एंड चेक आउट ऑफ दैट अर्ली एंड टू कॉल इट बुलशिट एंड नॉट गेट इन टू बी अवेयर ऑफ गैस लाइटिंग, बी अवेयर ऑफ you know, bullying, be aware of people taking advantage and move out of it sooner. But if it is a beautiful atmosphere where people are empowering each other, my office is democratic. I have a team of 30 people that work with me. They're amazing women across. I mean, I've never even seen the lens of, I mean, of course, I understand my office is led by me and evolved, inspired people. But I would say that there are many, many offices like this in Bombay. Like if you see the top 10 or top 20 films of the year, you know, maybe start with those. Try and be an intern in one of those offices. At least there will be equality there. At least there will be, you know, they were thinking before putting this content out there. Don't just think that, acha, ye koi film bana rahe, mujhe koi to chance mil raha hai. You know, then you are walking, understand the atmosphere you are walking into. You know, so... don't put yourself through that and work hard. And if you are an intern at a good office space, at an inspired, encouraging, office space, you will only grow. And I have been there in those positions where I've said, I don't like the atmosphere, you know. I've done Mata Ke Jagrata videos as a production assistant, you know, so in Delhi. And I've just said, you know, mujhe samajh nahi aa raha thoda. You know, shayad mujhe ye nahi karna chahiye. So from there, I've done international films, yaar, where people treat you like equals, where the producer is sharing their emails with you. You know, and then it is your ownership to be honest to your work. अच्छा वर्क कल्चर किसको कहते हैं, यू नो, सो यू नो फॉर योर सेल्फ. लाइक माई माता के जगराता वीडियोज वर नॉट अच्छा वर्क कल्चर, यू नो, बहुत हेक्टिक था, क्योटिक था, और सब जज कर रहे थे, सब वन मैन अपशिप कर रहे थे. नहीं करो ना वहाँ पे काम. यहाँ पर जहाँ फ्री फ्लो ऑफ इन्फॉर्मेशन है, जहाँ हायरार्की ज़्यादा नहीं है, जहाँ मतलब डेमोक्रेसी है, जहाँ आपके आइडियाज़ लिए जाते हैं, आई थिंक यंग पीपल चेंज द वर्ल्ड. आई मीन, इफ आई डोंट हैव यंग पीपल अराउंड मी, देन देयर इज नो पॉइंट, देयर इज नो ग्रोथ. यू नो, आई डोंट नो एवरीथिंग हियर इन माई ऑफिस. एवरीबडी हैज एन ओपिनियन एंड एवरीबडी गिव्स रिटन ओपिनियंस ऑन एवरीथिंग वी रीड. वी डू वीकली कॉल्स, वी डू जॉइंट डिस्कशंस, वी डोंट गो बैक ऑन, वी डोंट टेक सिंगुलर डिसीजंस. सो यू नो, stay in a place that, you know, helps you become a better person and makes you more aware in any profession.
Can we unmute Purva Dinesh, please?
Hi, thanks, Smriti. Thanks, Kalpana. Am I allowed to compliment Sikhya before I ask my question?
Oh, yes, please.
Right. So, Guneet, and this is to everybody who's watching. I mean, my first, you know, similar call with Guneet was last year. I'm a documentary filmmaker, very recently started my career. I got an email address to write to in Sikhya. I did that. I got a reply within a week. The next week we were on a call. Sikhya loved my work, shot a documentary series of mine. Literally a dream come true. Now I get messages from Guneet's team members asking me if I would be interested in a certain, whatever, certain subjects. And it really seems surreal. Like a year ago, I was here in a similar, you know, setup where I really didn't know too many people. It's just something that I wanted to do. So I really congratulate Guneet, you and the team, to make yourself so accessible. I mean, just the fact that emails were getting answered means so much. I mean, it really means the world.
It means a lot to me. Thank you, Purva. It really, really means a lot to me because I've been that person globally wanting people to answer my emails. It means a lot to me that our emails are answered. My team is there. And even sustaining the team, even building, choosing this team has been, I feel very blessed with everybody that I work with. Achin, Aliza, Alia, Manpreet, Ronak, everybody at the team, Pravar, just it's beautiful. Ritika, Sagar, you know, Simran, Harsri, Vedant, anybody that you have interacted with at Sikhya. I feel very, very blessed that we all work very hard. We're also always playing catch up. But I feel bad about the 10 scripts I get on my WhatsApp. You know, I feel like there is a process, guys. Let's just follow the process. We will show up. We will revert. We've worked with so many first-time writers, directors. We revert to everything. So I keep trying to put a process in place. And I think people who don't follow the process, I mean, I've followed that process globally, and it's very important to do that, you know. So yeah, but thank you, Purva. You've made my day. Thank you.
I'm glad.
I'm going to send treats to everybody at their homes now.
Thank you.
Right. My question, Guneet, a really quick one is, I personally was very excited when I saw Indian Women Rising, because as a documentary filmmaker, as a woman documentary filmmaker in the country, there is no ecosystem. Like any career that we have is really abroad. It really feels that we get more support there overseas, where I tend to know more people than here in India. But I would be really excited to know if you have any concrete strategies in place, like how do you see yourself promoting Indian filmmakers, women filmmakers, just to sort of give you a small context is, you know, when I have discussions, let's say with Aliza from Secure, you know, another big production house has shopped a script of mine, and my questions to everybody is the same, that if production houses like yours can, you know, just, and I know how the industry works, but just sort of just give some sort of token budget, like just say, we can give you only 30 grand, we can give you only 40 grand. That's all that we can afford, but start doing this, especially with documentaries where, you know, it's really character driven, situation driven. I can't really wait for 6 months, 7 months before, you know, I start developing something. Just go thoda sa pyar dikhao. Like, you guys show so much love by shopping it and taking it around. But can it be extended to just giving something so that at least I can go and start with my research? At least I can go and start living with my, staying with my characters in whatever I get. Because yeah, then I find myself in a situation where, right, I'm working on five films, developing five films, and I see myself putting my money in all the five films because I really don't know when will I get that little bit so that I can continue my work.
No, absolutely, Purva. I think if anything is commissioned, it has to be paid. There has to be a proper contract. There is a constant hustle that everyone does, you know, because similarly at your level, where you are asking a producer this, as an independent producer, I can ask studios this because they give us briefs and they say, okay, come back to us. You know, there's no culture of them saying, okay, here is a startup money, come back to us. So that culture is trickled down, you know. So we get briefs and then we work very hard to try and convert the brief. You know, it's about being in that ecosystem where we can share the briefs with some people that we love. So if something is commissioned, absolutely it's paid. But something that is not commissioned is always, you have to understand how the ecosystem entirely works. You know, so, and it's, you know, and it's very easy. It's very, the position of running a production company, running the teams, running the structure is very hard, you know, and the, of course, pandemic hasn't made it any easier. So, absolutely. And your question on Indian women rising, I would say we aspire to discover, amplify and distribute. So if there's a film that you've made, you can send it to us. You can send it to Ritika@secure.in or even at IWR website, there is a email ID and you will have a response. And mostly it will be Ritika@secure.in responding. You will have a response. And if that film speaks to us, it can be a short, it can be any genre. We will put all our might behind it. To get it distributed, to get it amplified, get it released, and exactly what we did with Pittu. So we're looking, and this is a conversation I wanted to actually have with Smriti, because I think at Mami and at Smriti and, you know, Kalpana, they see so many early films. If there is a film that, you know, and even any one of you think, you know, you want to send it our way and it's directed by a woman, because that is our core agenda, that is our core focus, please send it to us and we will put everything behind our power to have an ecosystem and to have it distributed and have it seen, heard, championed, cheered, reviewed, spoken about and released. And all of us, Ekta, Ruchika, Taira, me, we're all doing our independent work, but in this case, we come for amplification and distribution. So yeah.
Lovely. Can we unmute Aniket Roomde, please? Finally.
Hello. Can you guys hear me?
Go for it.
Yeah, so sorry. My helicopter headphones is just so that people can hear me clearly. Yeah. I recently made a film which got selected on Hotstar and everything, you know. And I wrote a new film and I'm pitching it. And it was like a creative all-in for me. And I'm trying to write a new film. Now, the question I have for you is, Gunit, is how difficult... you know how pitching is difficult. You have spoken a lot about it. Writing is also difficult. Or should I write a film which I can shoot it in a 40-50 lakh budget and try to sell it to a platform. Will that be a good gig, or should I try to write a film which is local, which I can take to festivals? Like, I have taken the script and written to Indian film festivals. I have won awards also, but you know, it's difficult to get the money trickling in. So should I focus my energies on maybe writing a local film, taking to the world screenplay market, or should I try to make a 50 lakh?
Just keep life simple and make a good film. It's a short, it's a feature, it's a documentary. Ask yourself every day how it can be better. What do I need to do? How can my storytelling be better? You know, do you need to do a masterclass for that? Do you need to get yourself a script doctor for that? You know, do you need to get into a lab for that? Just make a good film. You will make a good short film. You will get noticed. There are people in my office who will call you, who will reach out and call you and say, we want to know what you're doing next. So there are people in every production company who will call you and say that, Aniket, we want to know what you're doing next. So just make a good film and be driven on saying, acha, this is my first idea. Shayad ye itna achha nahi hoga. Ye shayad low hanging fruit hai. How do I make it better? So when you start asking that question to your piece of material, you start informing yourself on making a better version of your film. That's what I do every time when we did 17 drafts of Paglet, you know. So every day, every time we ask ourselves that how can this be even better? We share our scripts. I've built an ecosystem around people giving feedback. And we come back with feedback. So it's a process of making it better. It does not happen better by one single mind. It gets better with constructive feedback, with growth, and that is creative producing. So just make a good film. There's no word like local, international festival, nothing. Achha hoga, pura desh aapke paas chal kar aayega.
Komal Agrawal, can we unmute Komal, please? Hey, Komal, go for it.
Thank you so much. So I'll quickly shoot my question, understanding the time limits. So ma'am, as we see the global scenario right now, the pandemic, how we are restricted a little. So do you think the ways of making the films, getting them, the reach and the release, etc., has changed due to this pandemic situation? Is there some other kind of strategy one has to follow? Are you following another different kind of strategy during this scenario?
I took two of my films to OTTs, you know, they were both made for cinemas, Surya Rai Potru and Paglet. They both, Surya Rai Potru went to, which is a Tamil film with amazing Surya.
Yeah.
On the Life of Captain Gopinath, directed by the most amazing Sudha Gongara. So that went to Amazon, and Paglet went to Netflix, which is written and directed by Umesh Pisht with Sanya Malhotra. So that was my strategy, because that was like our collective strategy as a team because of the pandemic, you know.
Ma'am, one important question I've been trying to ask. How do you select your content? Because all your content we have seen, they are out of the box or unique in their own way. So personally, what do you have a checklist when you select your content? What do you see? And also you were talking about your films are going to be released in 2023 maybe. So at that time, how do you know that they are going to be relevant for that time? So that kind of foreshadowing or foreseeing, I mean, do you look for that?
I think I answered that saying that our exposure defines who we are, right? And our taste defines who we are. We make choices for many reasons. We make choices for money. We make choices for love. We make choices for changing the world, impact cinema, impact conversations. Whatever choice we make to tell a story, why are we telling this story? Why are we putting, why I said 2023 is because 2 saal lagte hain picture banane mein, you know, overnight nahi banti. To jo main abhi se kar rahi hun, jab actor dates aayengi, jab hum log shoot karenge, phir hum post karenge, phir music hoga, sab hoga. So, karte karte 2023 ho jayega. I hope 2022 mein picture aa jaye bahar, you know. But depending when we shoot it, you know, I hope 2021 I can release my next film. But that's wishful thinking. Practical thinking, 2023 mein I think you will see the work that I'm putting down. I'm right now working, Sikhya is building a slate of 15 feature films. We will be announcing 7 of them next month. So it is just, it is, when are these films coming out? You know, when are they happening and when are they coming out? Will be 2023, hopefully. And then how do we stay relevant? It is completely work done. It is, of course, informing ourselves with what, where the world is, where it can go. Stories that we love, that they touch our heart, they touch our gut. It's very, very intuitive. It's very instinctive. And then the filmmaker on the other side, you know, and then if we can see the same vision, it's like a little, you're in a relationship with your filmmaker. You know, you have to be on the same page. It's like, we are together in this, building this world together. What I do have a very, I definitely have a lens on how women are represented in cinema, how each character is informed. I definitely have those conversations. And I definitely try and expand those conversations within the team. So any film that I am part of, I definitely have that lens post the Me Too movement, and understanding feminism and deeply resonating with that and just building characters around that where, you know, whatever we can do in our way, in our entertainment industry, we should. Outside of that, I'm very motivated by impact cinema, especially short documentaries, docs, real life. So we have a whole slate of around 10 documentaries also, which will be announced, and we have been shooting some. In fact, we shot 2 documentaries during the lockdowns last year. So they are all on edit right now. I think I will have some releases in 2021 too. So we will know more, but you know what, we follow our heart, and I hope I can always continue to do that. And I hope we can always be relevant and do our best, you know, and we kill ourselves trying to get feedback from everybody we know around. I work on a format of getting a lot of feedback. More negative feedback is better. It helps us inform what we can be ready for in the world. And that's the work that we do on every piece of content.
Okay, I'm going to take last 2 questions. I thought I'll end 2 questions before, but I'm just getting greedy. And whichever questions are not answered, I will send those to Guneet and she will reply to us and we will send those across to you. So please be patient. Can I request Brigav Dua to be unmuted, please? And then Anusha will be next, and that's where we'll end. Go for it, Brigav.
Yeah, hi. I'm Brigav Dua, a student of Whistling Woods International. I recently started my own production company. What is that you would suggest me at this stage to make an impact and sustain based on your experiences and how people like just starting out as a filmmaker in the industry can get in touch with you?
So Sikhya website, please get in touch with me. Sikhya team, there are so many creative producers in the team. There's Manpreet, there's Ronak, there's Aliza, our head of development is Alia. There is Prabhar who heads the company. There is Achin who's my partner. There is Ritika Sagar in marketing communications. We are so many of us. You can contact us. You can go through the website. You can contact us for sure. But because you are starting out, I would say look at short content. Look at short series. Look at what the world, like there has been Snapchat series, like what we did with Flipkart, which is short series. When you look at a piece of content, ask yourself, is this a short or is this a short I'm trying to make into a feature? You know, don't just think it's just a picture. Banana hai. Aaj dunya bahut badi ho gayi hai and we won an Oscar for short documentary. You know, I hope one day we win for a feature film. But this is what the truth is. Like our work was put on the map because we were a part of short documentary as Sikhya. So look at every piece of content and inform yourself that can this IP be a short film, a short documentary, or a feature film, or a docu-feature? Because today there are so many opportunities, there are so many content ke liye buyers. Hain. So you don't have to be in the queue that I don't have an actor date, so I don't have money, I don't have a job. You know, today you can do podcasts. We sustained Sikhya by doing 5 podcasts last year. You know, please listen to Dosa King and on Spotify or Jabbi Sex at
nice, lovely.
At Audible, you know, or even Mafia Land at Spotify, you know. So I would just say, you know, today you can sustain with so much that is going on. And if we can sustain at a level of Sikhya, I mean, you're starting out with not such so many so many team members and so many expenses and so many permanent expenses of a company, of an office, of a structure, of an accounts team, of, you know, taxes, of handling, managing so many IPs of so many years and everything that that IP needs to be serviced. It's a lot of work in the business, doing the business. So look at what is available and look what you can translate immediately. And there are so many digital actors and there is so much short content happening, and that is also the future. So start where you can and don't wait.
Thank you. The last question, Anusha Datta. Can we unmute Anusha, please?
Hi. Hi, Gunit. So I think a lot of my queries were answered because the other participants asked similar questions. But again, I'm from the background of being a writer-director for documentary films. And the biggest problem I have faced in the last 2-3 years that I've been working is with money. So I have done commissioned projects, but then, you know, when I'm trying to develop something of my own, how do I potentially scale my project? Because I keep wondering, at what stage will I be able to approach a producer to ask for a certain amount of money? And if I'm not able to do that, then do I just stick to it being, you know, of a certain scale? Because when I write and develop that idea, it depends on how much money I can potentially use to let that idea, you know, reach its point in making.
So write an amazing pitch, definitely. I think pitches is something that we have to do at our own end. We do it at our level. Every being in film is also a bit of an entrepreneurship. So of course, write pitches, be as advanced as you can, whatever you can do. And reach out to producers, you know, because now there are buyers in the market for docs. Also know what kind of docs people want. You know, there are so many, from Verite to wildlife to, you know, just interview based to archive based. Just there's so many kinds of docs. There's such good work happening in India, around the world. So either work with a team that is doing a lot, or know what the world wants. Inform yourself. Don't work in isolation. You know, so again, build an ecosystem around yourself. Build a peer group around yourself. That's very important for growth to happen, so that you don't feel like, oh my God, I'm in the burden of my own ideas and working in isolation for so long. So it's important to work with a team. It's important to know that team. It's important to see where they are going. What are they looking for? I've just sent you an email ID on the chat window. So Aliza at Sikya heads everything nonfiction. Somebody in the team just now spoke about her also. So you can reach out to her, book a call. What are your ideas? What is it that the company is looking for? You know, and then inform yourself with that, you know, so that you're not, you know, just if you're good and where you need to improve your craft, what is it that you need to know? So, yeah.
Gunit, thank you so much. I think we need to do a couple more sessions with you on very micro topics, not even something as large as from indie to epic. I also want to tell everyone who's watching this that this was a fantastic session. If you want more tips on producing and pitching, please go to Sudhanshu Saria's Dial M session, which was all about pitching, how to create pitches. And of course, the last session we did on Dial M for Films was with Siddharth Roy Kapoor, who also gave us brilliant insight into the world of producing. But Gunit, we must do a session on festivals, just a separate thing on festivals and revenue streams. Thank you so much for taking out so much of time, because I know how busy you are. We've not announced it as yet, but we are doing, it's not open to participate on with Zoom, but you can watch it on YouTube. But at 12 o'clock on Saturday, we are doing the second industry session at MAMI. It'll be streamed live. It's got 15 artists from the Malayalam film industry, and it's called Redefining Regional, the Malayalam edition. And if you'd like, you know, join us and ask questions. I can ask all of them who are coming in. We are announcing this tomorrow. So follow our social media handles and you'll get to know all the details of the session. But thank you so much for joining in, and stay safe, wear a mask, take all the precautions. Both Guneet and I know there are a few people who've got COVID who are attending right now, but we've got people in our families who've got COVID. It's not worth it. Just be as careful as you can. And at this point of time, nobody in India can afford to get COVID because we don't have medical supplies or infrastructure to do anything. So just please, stay safe.
I just want to take a moment and say that there is so much good work happening across languages. And thank you, Smriti, Kalpana, everybody at MAMI, highlighting it. And also all young entrepreneurs, know that there is a world outside Hindi, and there's incredible work happening in Tamil, Telugu, Malayalam, especially in Bengali and in Assamese with Three Madhas, of course. There's so much great work happening, so you can start your producing journey anywhere, you know. Take films to festivals, do that hustle, build that peer group, build that, you know, build a vision and say, okay, I need to meet these 10 people, you know. Who are the people who sold that film? I need to meet those 10 people and just get out there and do it. So yeah.
Become language agnostic, guys. So take care, everybody. And thank you so much for joining us. And Guneet, thank you for giving us so much of your time.
I'm really grateful. Thank you.